Okay, so if you didn't know, there's a sequel to Zombieland coming out today. Zombieland Double Tap dropped in theaters today. So if you're interested in seeing that, it's there. If you've never seen the original, I highly recommend it. It came out like 10 years ago. It's been a while. So long, in fact, that I'm surprised they even made this movie. Because usually you have like a time limit on when you can make sequels. Especially for a movie that's, you know, not really as big or at least as much as a cult favorite. I don't know if you would call this movie a cult favorite. I think people just like it. I enjoyed it quite a bit. I thought it was funny. I also think it's a perfect in time length. It's only like 90 minutes. It's a very short movie, but every scene in the movie just kind of kicks. Anyway, I liked the movie a lot. So I do plan on going to see this sequel probably next week, like I said. It's in a good position to do well as there's not much in the theaters this week. I think there's a Cinderella movie or something based on the witch in the movie. I don't know. I'm not interested in that movie. Not going to go see it. This I will see. However, as with any new drop, we get the hot takes coming out. But one thing I want to highlight real quick is once again, critics and audiences seem to disagree highly as the score is already at a 65%. Not too many hot takes. And then the audience score is at a 94%. So it's doing decent among audiences, which means it's probably a good movie. I think anytime you see a drastic difference between critics and audiences, you can probably bank that the movie's decent to go see. Critics, I don't feel, represent anybody other than their own little niche group of weirdos. However, that's not really the purpose of the video. The video is that it's already being attacked by these people. As you can see right here, in Zombieland Double Tap, the real monster is 2009 error. Misogyny.
How dare you?
So, why are they so mad? And don't get it twisted. It's going to be more than Polygon that are mad about this. You're going to see other outlets mad too. Why is that? Well, let me explain. You see here, this blonde chick next to Wichita, Emma Stone. She's a new character that they pick up somewhere, and she's apparently an airhead blonde bimbo. Now, you know that there are several stereotypic traits to that, as well as jokes that can be made. And they call this, you know, old antiquated joking. It's not. You should never use the woman as a love interest and as a butt of jokes. And that's what they do. So they joke on her, they make fun of her. And that's a big problem because now they're using the woman as a prop. See, they would have no problem if it was a man. But because it's a woman, that's different because women must be empowered at all times in every single form of entertainment nowadays. It's almost kind of become a joke. So I want to be clear, there's a little bit of spoilers here, but I don't think anything too bad to where if you haven't seen the trailer, which I'm sure most of you probably have, how would you know the movie's coming if you haven't? And I think most people watch trailers. You'll know what's going on here. Basically, Little Rock takes off because she wants to be around other people her own age, and they go after her. They do spoil one thing, though, that there's a new breed of zombie on the rise that's stronger. That's not really a big deal. I don't think that really ruins anything. So they go after her, and that's where the hilarity ensues. However, they don't like that the blonde girl and Wichita are in a love triangle with Columbus. I forget his name. Not Woody Harrelson, but the guy who plays Columbus. But there's a love triangle for him, and they don't like that. That's old. That's old plot points. So we can just skip down here to where they get into their argument. So the actress who plays Madison has a total commitment to the part of airheaded blonde bimbo, and it almost saves the role, but the degree to which the script seems to resent both her and Wichita drags the whole enterprise down every female character, including Rosera Dawson as Nevada, who runs an Elvis-themed motel, exists to be a love interest, fulfilling either the emotionally unavailable cool girl or sexually available hot girl trope. Now, they have a stereotype trope type thing for every type of woman, isn't it? Don't they? The only one that's acceptable to these weirdos is badass chick. And even that, I'm sure they have a problem with if she shows too much thigh or shows too much cleavage or something. You know how it is with these people. It's almost ruined American entertainment because you can't have the love interest like this anymore. You can't do that. You can't write films like this anymore without getting destroyed by these people. And that's why I'm saying you're going to see more takes like this. And I would imagine more reviews as they come out will probably pin this role down for that and the female characters. You know, you can't just write the stories anymore. What's worse is the Madonna whore dichotomy is used as a weapon. I've never even heard of this. Madison and Wichita are pitted against each other, and Wichita made out to be a killjoy for being uncertain about commitment, and Madison a meanless fling for being sexually liberated. Neither can win, and both are thrown under the bus. No one is more trampled and mistreated than Madison, who is the butt of almost every joke. Well, wouldn't that be the point, since she's an airhead blonde? I mean, literally, as soon as she's introduced, you're going to know what she is. I think she's there to be the butt of every joke because she's a bimbo. That's kind of the point. But these people can't sit there and just enjoy the entertainment. They have to take issue with every single aspect that women characters are portrayed in, because everything with that is a problem unless they're some kind of intellectual giant or leader or something. But make no mistake, if it's a dumb guy like that 2016 Ghostbuster disaster they did with what's his name who played Thor, who was a complete moron in the movie, they liked that. That was just fine. You won't see these articles for characters like that because they don't exist, because they don't care. It's a double standard. So they go on to say, in the year of our Lord 2019, I kept expecting there to be a turn for Madison to reveal some unexpected talent, or for her and Wichita to get over their shared relations with an untimely kind of guy, but no go. So they would have united in women power and got rid of Columbus and realized they don't need no man. They don't need no man. No man needed. That's what they wanted to see. It didn't happen. Guarantee at the end of the movie, Wichita and Columbus probably hook up and get married or something. And I'm sure that bothered them even more because, you know, it's 2019. You don't need no man, ladies. You don't need him. And that's what they want to admit. You know how this could have been a revolutionary movie if the two female characters hooked up. That would have definitely pleased them. But I don't think that happened, and that disappointed the reviewer here very much. Zombieland Double Tap is firmly stuck in 2009, antiquated, gender politics and all. Of course, that's a problem. You know, we don't have anybody playing a different pronoun in here. Also an issue. And that's not to mention a billboard scene in which a driveway is used as a metaphor for Nevada's nether regions. Oh my. It already sounds funny to me. Already sounds funny. These dynamics feel rotten given how entertaining the rest of the film can be. Madison seems to be having fun despite everything, and Harrelson turns his ham bone comic chops up to 11 as he kicks and screams his way through the wasteland, even briefly dressing up as Elvis. Luke Wilson and Thomas Middleditch have some obvious fun too, as doppelgangers for Tallahassee and Columbus, who show up halfway through the movie to cause a little chaos. That was also in the trailer. Thought that was kind of funny. Pretty much the same character right here, and they just kind of have fun with it. Not really a big deal. A demented final or mid-credits scene that capitalizes on the biggest celebrity cameo in the first movie is the cherry on top of the very sour cake. Set during a press junket, it casts film critics as the enemy, effectively defying anyone who dares to criticize its shallow sense of humor. The scene also makes it clear that Double Tap doesn't have anything to give that wasn't in the original movie, which I'm now afraid to revisit, lest it turn out to be as bad as the sequel it spawned. Don't want to go back and see those old whammin' jokes. Now, what I find funny here is the butthurt that they apparently make fun of film critics. Can you imagine it? See, they don't like that, because these film critics, as outdated as they are, they don't really have any power. Look at Joker. As much as they tried to destroy Joker, and boy, oh boy, did they try. It didn't work. And the movie's going to make $1 billion. And you know, I think part of the success of that $1 billion is the destruction of film critics. And how every time they try to do this stuff, it backfires and people end up going and seeing it. And they don't like it pointed out that they're complete jokes now, and nobody really cares about their opinions anymore. You know where people go for film reviews? YouTube. That's where they go. They go, or they go to some blog they found and like. They or somebody on Twitter that they like. You know, they don't go to the blue check marks anymore. Social media and YouTube have brought light to new people to review things. People that are more relatable to people and aren't, you know, some kind of coffee sipping pompous ass at a Starbucks over in California. And I love that this movie pretty much makes fun of them. This mid-credit scene, I guarantee you, you're going to see a lot of butthurt fifis about that. You're going to see a lot of reeking and reeing and screeching over it. And I think that's a beautiful thing. I love that. So I love that this movie doesn't care. I love that this movie slaps on critics. I love that they brought back blonde jokes because that apparently is going to cause some butthurt. Whether the movie's good or not, I don't know. I'm going to go see it. Maybe I'll talk about it on a live stream or something. But I'm pretty excited for it. I'm a big fan of the original. And I think it's funny that once again, you know, we have a property come out and critics got to come out and, you know, make fun of it and pretty much try to destroy it. Will it work this time? I doubt it. I'm sure it'll do just fine. Anyway, leave me your comments below. Tell me what you thought about the video. What do you think about Polygon? What do you think about Zombieland? Have you seen it? Let me know if you liked it. And as always, I'll see you guys on the next one. Also, don't forget to share the video, like the video, make sure you're still subscribed, and I'll see you guys real soon. Peace.